did it, Snake. You shot down the Hind.
I was so worried.
Liquid couldn't have survived that.
I wonder. But even so, just because we've taken out their leader doesn't mean they're gonna give up. They're still gonna try to launch that nuke.
You're right. There's no time to waste. Hurry. The underground base is past the communications tower. The elevator's working again, isn't it?
My God! You actually shot down that Hind!
You're the one who said I could do it with a stinger. You didn't really think I had a chance, did you?
It's not that. Well, after all, that Hind shot down two F-16s. It is hard to believe that after doing that, it got taken out by just one man. Nice going, Snake.
What can I do for you, Snake? Come on, Snake. Don't call me for no reason.
Thank you. Snake, there's something I forgot to tell you before.
What?
There were 5 stealth camouflage prototypes in my lab.
Yeah, so?
If you take out the one I'm wearing, that leaves 4.
Hey, this isn't first grade math class.
I thought I'd get one for you. So I went back to the lab and...
Yeah?
The 4 suits were missing. Also, about the elevator that I checked out, it's really strange. It was like someone was intentionally holding it.
When you were riding on it, did the weight limit warning go off?
That's another thing that bothered me about it. The warning went off, and I know I couldn't be over the limit.
How much do you weigh?
About 135. But that elevator had a weight limit of 650 pounds.
It would take at least 5 people to go over that limit.
Look out, Snake! The guys who stole my stealth prototypes are in there with you!
Too late, Snake! Now die!
Otacon, which direction is the underground base?
It's in the snowfield to the north of Tower B. The door is security level 6.
You found body armor. It will lower the damage you take from gunfire. It is designed to prevent bullets from penetrating, but you will still feel the impact from the bullets. Don't rely on it too much.
That inner voice that warns you when danger is nearby.
The entrance to the underground maintenance base is somewhere towards the...
Snake, are you okay?
Otacon, were there any other stealth prototypes?
No, there were only five.
So, this isn't stealth camouflage then?
What are you talking about?
Someone's aiming at me, in the middle of this blizzard.
It's her!
Wolf? Sniper Wolf?
Yes, it's her. It's definitely her.
Otacon, you sound like you're happy.
No, I'm not.
So then what is it?
Snake, please don't kill her.
Are you insane?
Please, she's a good person. You'd know that if you talked to her.
Listen to me, kid. She's a merciless killer.
I can see you perfectly from here. I told you, I'd never quit the hunt. Now you're mine.
Wolf, no, you can't.
Don't get between a wolf and its prey.
You're pretty good if you can hit me in this storm.
You see, women naturally make better soldiers.
Wolf, don't do this.
Snake, I'm near. Can't you sense me near you?
It's a mistake for a sniper to reveal our location.
Is that right? Well, I'm going to send you a love letter, my dear. Do you know what that is? It's a bullet straight from my gun to your heart.
Please, Wolf! Snake, no!
Quiet! Don't get in our way!
Now I'm gonna pay you back for Meryl.
You men are so weak. You can never finish what you start.
Otacon, where can I find ammo for the PSG-1?
I can't tell you.
Sniper Wolf. It is pretty unusual for a sniper to announce their presence before they shoot. She must have a real thing for you. Anyway, I do not think it is going to be as easy as before.
The most important tools you need to be a good sniper are the senses that you were born with. No amount of training can change those. If your senses are dull from the beginning, you'll never be a great sniper.
It's Sniper Wolf. You can only shoot at her with your PSG-1.
Snake, Wolf is hiding somewhere in that snowfield. First, you'll have to find out where she is.
She should come out of hiding briefly to shoot at you.
Thank you.
do not drastically reduce the number of stockpiled nuclear weapons...
So, you beat Wolf, huh? She was a fool to use the same tactics that failed her in your first meeting. But remember, don't let down your guard until you've got a confirmed kill.
It looks like Wolf is down. Now get to Metal Gear's underground base on the double.
Waited for this moment. I am a sniper. Waiting is my job. Never moving a muscle. Concentrating. I am long shot. You cannot save me. Please. Just finish me quick. I am a guard. I have always dreamed of a peaceful place like this.
A guard? So that's why you're called Wolf.
I was born on a battlefield. Raised on a battlefield. Gunfire, sirens, and screams. They were my lullabies. Hunted like dogs, day after day. Riven from our ragged shelters. That was my life. Each morning I'd wake up and find a few more of my family or friends dead beside me. I'd stare at the morning sun and pray to make it through the day. The governments of the world turned a blind eye to our misery. But then, he appeared. My hero. Saladin. He took me away from all that.
Saladin? You mean Big Boss?
I became a sniper. Hidden. Watching everything through a rifle scope. Now I could see war. Not from inside, but from the outside. As an observer. I watched the brutality. The stupidity of mankind through the scope of my rifle. I joined this group of revolutionaries to take my revenge on the world. But I have shamed myself and my people. I am no longer the wolf I was born to be. In the name of vengeance, I sold my body and my soul.
Wolves are noble animals. They're not like dogs. In Yupik, the word for wolf is Keglenek, and the Aleuts revere them as honorable cousins. They call mercenaries like us dogs of war. It's true. We're all for sale at some price or another. But you're different. Untamed. Solitary. You're no dog. You're a wolf.
Who are you? Are you Saladin?
Wolf. You spared Meryl's life.
She was never my real target. I don't kill for sport.
Rest easy. You'll die as the proud wolf you are.
I finally understand. I wasn't waiting to kill people. I was waiting for someone to kill me. A man like you. You're a hero. Please. Set me free.
Why? Why? I loved you.
What is it?
My gun. Give it to me. She's part of me. Everyone's here now. Oh, okay, hero. Set me free.
Goodbye. Snake, you said that love could bloom on the battlefield. But I couldn't save her. What are you doing?
Returning it to its owner. I don't need a handkerchief.
Why?
I don't have any more tears to shed. I'm going to the underground base. We're out of time.
I know.
You'll have to protect yourself now. Don't trust anyone.
Yeah.
If I can't stop Metal Gear, this whole place will probably be bombed to hell.
Yeah.
We might not meet again.
I'll hang on to my codec. I want to keep helping.
You can leave anytime. Get a head start. A head start on your new life.
Snake! What was she fighting for? What am I fighting for? What are you fighting for?
If we make it through this, I'll tell you.
Okay. I'll be searching too.
Entrance to the underground maintenance base is in the north of the snowfield. I'll be watching, Snake.
As long as the strategy of nuclear deterrence continues...
Master, you and I, we're nothing more than dogs, are we?
That's not like you, Snake. Don't let what Sniper Wolf said bother you. Listen, there's not a soldier alive that doesn't question himself. And if there is one, he's nothing more than a murderer. But someone like Wolf, a soldier who's looking for nothing more than their own death, is no good to anyone either. Once she started to look for death, it was all over. That's how you'll end up too, Snake.
A sad story. We shouldn't have turned our backs on the Kurds after the Gulf War. Listen, we're not responsible for her choices. Everyone decides their own fate, no matter where they were born. Words like fate, karma, it's just an excuse for giving up, if you ask me.
I don't agree with you.
Maybe if she hadn't been born on a battlefield, she might have had a happier, more fulfilling life. She might not have turned into a killer.
Thank you. the box.
he is!
It looks like that elevator you were riding on won't go any further down. Switch to the other elevator.
Plan your strategy based on the enemy's positions. Try to think like the enemy commander would think. If you can put yourself in the map designer's mind, a lot of doors will open for you.
There is no doubt about it. After the Cold War ended, the chance of a full-scale, worldwide nuclear conflagration was diminished. But on the other hand, the chances of local tactical use of nuclear weapons greatly increased. Civil wars, revolutions, regional disputes. It seems like there is a new war popping up somewhere every day. And many of them are the result of centuries-old hatred between different ethnic or religious groups. These people do not think rationally or logically. In such conflicts, there is no concern for the high civilian casualty rate, and international criticism means little. A nuclear deterrent is meaningless because emotions run so hot. Furthermore, unlike strategic nuclear missiles, the decision to use tactical nuclear missiles is in some cases left up to battlefield commanders. It is pretty scary. As long as nuclear weapons continue to proliferate, the chances that someone is going to use them will also continue to grow.
Snake, that's the relay point between Elevator 1 and Elevator 2.
Why was it set up this way?
Well, for a long time it had been set up so that you could take one elevator all the way to the bottom. But I heard that they changed it because of something to do with the structural integrity of the rock. The number 2 elevator is next to you, right? Transfer to that one.
straight down. Better move it. There's no time. The terrorists are ready to launch.
Negotiations are all finished.
The government can't cave into terrorist demands.
But they're threatening to launch a nuclear weapon.
They've made their final decision.
Why is the White House being so inflexible? Colonel, is there still something you're hiding from me?
Snake, please. Just concentrate on stopping them, okay?
There are a lot of crows around here.
Those aren't crows. Those are northern ravens. The Inuit and other Native Americans worship northern ravens as creator deities. Some say that ravens have the power to predict death. The great poet Marlowe wrote about them in the 16th century. Thus, like the sad presaging raven that tolls the sick man's passport in her hollow beak, and in the shadow of the silent night doth shake contagion from her sable wings.
That's pretty gloomy, Master.
By the way...
What?
I've got something to tell you about Naomi Hunter.
What about her?
Is this conversation secure?
Don't worry, the monitor's off.
Okay.
What's up?
I was in the FBI too, you know.
I didn't know that. What's your point?
Dr. Hunter's story about her background, about her grandfather being an assistant secretary to Hoover in the FBI.
Yeah.
And then going undercover to investigate the mafia in New York.
Yeah, what about it?
It was all a big lie.
What did you say?
It was really bothering me. Why would she lie about it?
She lied.
She might be a spy.
Ridiculous.
Come on, even a high school student could see past it. The head of the FBI at that time, Edgar Hoover, he was a well-known racist. Didn't Naomi say that her father was Japanese?
Yeah.
Well, back then, there wasn't a single Asian investigator. Also, in the 1950s, the undercover mafia sting operations hadn't even started yet. They first started in 1960, in Chicago, not New York.
But...
You better check it out. The chief and the president mysteriously dying, and that ninja, too many strange things are happening.
Are you saying that Naomi might be behind it?
I don't know. Either that, or she's working with the terrorists.
Could it be?
If I find out anything, I'll call. In the meantime, be careful.
Colonel, where's Naomi?
I'm right here, Snake. What is it?
Oh, nothing. Forget it.
Strange.
Snake, by now those terrorists have finished their launch preparations. Stop wasting time.
Welcome, Cossack. This is the end of the road for you. Right, my friends? Listen, they agree. Ravens aren't scavengers like most people think. They're simply returning to the natural world, that which is no longer needed. Sometimes they even attack wounded foxes.
You were the one in the M1 tank? Must have been a tight fit for a big boy like you.
But that was no true battle. The Ravens and I were testing to see what kind of man you were. The judgment is decided. The Ravens say you are a true warrior.
Am I hallucinating? I can't move.
The Raven has put the mark of death upon you. Blood from the East flows within your veins. Your ancestors too were raised on the barren plains of Mongolia. Inuit and Japanese are cousins to each other. We share many ancestors, you and I.
I don't have any crows in my family tree.
You jest, but indeed ravens and snakes are not the best of friends. Nevertheless, you will make a worthy adversary. You live in Alaska too. You know of the World Eskimo Indian Olympics?
Yeah, I know it. Must be a real threat in the muck duck eating contest.
Yes, you are right. But there is another event that I excel at. It is called the ear pull. It is an event where two opponents pull each other's ears while enduring the harsh cold. It tests spiritual as well as physical strength.
You want to pull each other's ears?
The form is different, but the spirit is the same. Rejoice, Snake! Ours will be a glorious battle.
This isn't glorious. It's just plain killing. Violence isn't a sport.
Well, we'll see if there's iron in your words.
Vulcan Raven is half Native Alaskan American and half Inuit. He was raised as a shaman, and they say he has supernatural powers. During the Cold War, he trained in Russia with the Bimbo, the Soviet Special Forces. In 1993, he was demoted by President Yeltsin following his coup d'etat, so he fled the country and became a mercenary. After that, he joined those rent-a-war bastards at Outer Heaven, Inc. He stayed there until he joined us in the Foxhound, thanks to a strong recommendation from Revolver Ocelot.
That cannon he's holding is a 20mm Vulcan gun. You usually see them mounted on fighter planes. You can't take him on in a firefight. He'll make mincemeat of you.
He's not just strong, Snake. He's a graduate emeritus from Alaska University, so he's a quick thinker, too.
In any case, you'd better not try to attack him from the front. Normal weapons are no match for his 20mm Vulcan. Try to attack him from the sides or behind.
That place is right in the middle of the permafrost. Just like the name says, it never melts. I've heard over 85% of Alaska is permafrost. It's extremely cold there, Snake. If you don't hurry, your sea rations will freeze. One way to prevent your sea rations from freezing is to hold them close to your body by equipping them.
It looks like Raven is holding an M61A1 20mm multi-turreted machine gun. They are usually mounted on F-16s. With its six rotating turrets, it can fire 4,020 millimeter rounds per minute, and it is accurate too. If you come at him from the front, he'll turn you into Borst.
That room is still under construction, because their main priority was to finish Metal Gear's underground base. But the good thing is, with all those containers, it should be easy to hide, right?
Up.
just as the boss said. It is my existence, which is no longer needed in this world. But my body will not remain in this place. My spirit and my flesh will become one with the ravens. In that way, I will return to Mother Earth who bore me. Snake! I will be watching you! Understand? Snake, take this security card. It will open that door.
Why?
You are a snake which was not created by nature. You and the boss. You are from another world. A world that I do not wish to know. Go and do battle with him. I will be watching from above. First, I'll give you a hint. The man who you saw die before your eyes.
What is it?
That was not the DARPA chief. It was Decoy Octopus, a member of Foxhound. He was a master of disguise. He copied his subjects down to the blood. So he drained the chief's blood and took it into himself. But he wasn't able to deceive the Angel of Death.
The Angel of Death? But why go to so much trouble? Why impersonate the chief?
That is the end of my hint. You must solve the rest of the riddle yourself. Snake, in the natural world, there's no such thing as boundless slaughter. There's always an end to it. But you are different.
What are you trying to say?
The path you walk on has no end. Each step you take is paved with the corpses of your enemies. Their souls will haunt you forever. You shall have no peace. Hear me, Snake. My spirit will be watching you.
Snake, it's me.
Master.
It's about Naomi. Turn your monitor off.
What about Naomi? Colonel, is Naomi there?
No, she's away. She's taking a short nap. So what is this about Naomi?
Okay, maybe we'd better let the Colonel hear this too.
Yeah, go on, Master.
Well, basically, Dr. Naomi Hunter is not Dr. Naomi Hunter at all.
What?
I thought her story of her background sounded kind of fishy, so I checked it out.
And?
There is an actual Dr. Naomi Hunter, or I should say, there was one. But she's not the woman we know. The real Naomi Hunter disappeared somewhere in the Middle East. Our Naomi must have somehow obtained her identification papers.
So then, who is she really?
She must be some kind of spy.
A spy?
Yes. Maybe she's been sent to sabotage this operation.
Are you saying she's with the terrorists?
I don't want to believe it either, but she is working for Foxhound.
So you think she had a part in the uprising?
Or she could be working with some different group altogether.
Different group? It couldn't be.
Place her under arrest.
What?
She's betrayed us. She needs to be arrested and interrogated to find out who she's with.
If she's one of their spies, then we're in big trouble.
What do you mean?
Nothing.
Have you let her in on some kind of vital secret or something? Does this have anything to do with the mysterious deaths of the DARPA chief and the Arms Tech president?
I have no idea.
Anyway, we cannot allow her to participate any further in this mission.
Wait a minute. Without her, we can't complete this mission.
I knew it. You're hiding something.
Give me some time. I'll try to get it out of her.
Hurry, then. We've got to figure out who she is and what she's doing here.
I understand. Snake, give me some time.
I don't have any time left for you.